I heard, you know, I had Hotboy Wes on here the other day. Like, y'all, y'all relative for real?
Yeah, we on Boss Talk 101.
Waco, man. I heard, you know, I had Hotboy Wes on here the other day. Like, y'all relative for real?
Yeah.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
How the hell I ain't know that?
This shit running the family for real.
Bro, that nigga was just on here, man, and I want to say I was the first Texas. He said I'm the first Texas interview he done. Being that you from Waco, is it tough? Like, most people say they have to leave out of their hometown because niggas be gunning for them because they hate like this. Is it something that you believe has to happen?
I ain't gonna lie. In Waco, where I'm from, like, it's some real gangsta-ass niggas down there.
That's crazy, but I'm just saying, y'all, I didn't think y'all even knew each other.
That's crazy. That's my nigga.
So y'all, did y'all plan this to make Waco hot? What was that all about?
It just happened like this.
Are you serious?
Real talk.
Damn, man, I just know when I looked over there, I had the boy named Giovanni the God came on. Is his name Giovanni?
Giovanni the Great.
The Great or whatever. He a little old dude. He be with Top Off. He be doing camera stuff.
From Waco. Yeah, that's my boy too.
Yeah, he came over here and from that night, I started focusing on Waco. Started looking like, damn, something over in Waco I need to be focused on.
Yeah, he said there's a lot of talent.
Yeah, he was telling me. And I called him.
We slept on like a bitch.
Yeah, I called him a month ago. About a month ago, I said, man, I'm coming to Waco. I want to do every nigga interview in Waco, nigga. He like, I don't know. I said, nigga, you better find them niggas, man. I'm gonna come up there and set up, nigga. I'm getting a room and everything.
That nigga Gio, he with this.
He like, man, I try to find him, man. He got some dude to call me. I don't even know who the dude was. But I'm like, man, I tell my baby, I'm like, we gonna make a blank trip up there. One of them niggas gonna come out. Cause I was gonna come set up. I set up, nigga.
Nah, I would've came out. I'm still in that bitch.
You still up there?
24/7, every day, all day.
Man, y'all got it.
I got kids and shit. I can't leave that home right now. Not right now.
How many kids you got?
I got two. I got a 9-year-old daughter. I got a 6-year-old stepson and my baby son, he 10 months.
That's dope, man. Shout out, man.
Yeah, that nigga bad.
You done? Bitch.
Yeah, I'm young. Can't get no more out of me.
Yeah, so when I think about just the fact that you're able to bring the music like that, it was one dude that I talked to, and I don't remember his name, but he was saying that, I do remember his name, it was Bone. Bone, the one that, homegirl Bone, that remember, she got a homegirl?
I know what you're talking about.
He was on here. And he was upset with the radio station in East Texas. Upset with the radio station in East Texas because he's from East Texas. And then he was like, but the dude in Waco, the radio dude, be messing with y'all. Precise. Say he always play y'all music and he support y'all. He was comparing Waco to East Texas, and he was saying that Waco radio stations support the hell out of the artists. Yeah, I said, really?
DJ Precise,
that's what he told me. Is that Precise, real? Or?
Yeah, he fucked with the whole city.
That's dope, man.
Yeah, it's genuine love. You don't
find it a lot.
Does that help? That help promote the music?
Yep, in Waco anyway, because, you know, that motherfucker smile. That hoe big, but that bitch smile. It ain't easy to come out that bitch. I ain't going to lie. It's like a 100-foot wall trying to get over that. And that's some shit in Waco, I ain't gonna lie.
Let me ask you this, so what's crazy? Like, give me some instances in where you didn't realize your stardom and somebody walked up to you and was like.
She didn't walk up to me, but we did pull up to the store a while ago, and the bitch was like, oh my God, this Waco Trump.
Are you serious?
Man, my bullshit. No cap, I ain't bullshit.
They watching, ain't they?
Yeah, it would be fucking me up.
They be doing that everywhere?
I was in LA. I was getting a hash dish. No, when I was buying some t-shirts.
Mighty Moses in the building, he's stepping up. Yeah, baby.
See, I was at the counter trying to buy the shirts and shit, and some little females, they was ringing me up. And they was like, can I ask you something and shit? I was like, what the fuck? I already knew where it was going, and then one bitch, I mean, my father, this she brought it, I ain't even call you a bitch, but look though. She came up and she was like, girl, it's on his hat. She ain't got to ask him because I had Waco Trump right here. She was like, don't ask him. It's on his hat. That's him. I was like, man, y'all crazy. How much these shirts cost, man? So I get the fuck up out of here.
But they love you. That's got to feel good because they're your fans, bro.
Good, yeah. Because coming from not getting no recognition in my own city to when I leave the city limits, motherfuckers fucking with me strong in the beat.
Yeah,
that's love.
I ain't gonna lie. I got off the flight in L.A. for the Super Bowl. The whole meet and greets and all that.
Yeah,
nigga said that's boss talk right there. I said, "Wee man,
nah,
it's getting
serious,
nigga.
Feeling, man.
It's getting serious, nigga.
Hey, that's not a good feeling.
He don't like it. He be running because he in the streets. He don't want
like that shit.
He don't be wanting them to see him. He like, oh,
hey, that feeling right there.
Somebody asked him in Big T. They say, "Ain't you Money Moses?"
It ain't even that. It's the
he said, "No, man, that's my brother."
I said my twin brother.
See, it's to the point I might start doing this. I ain't gonna drink like this, but
shit. You gonna have to.
I could be eating with my girl and sit in the kids. A motherfucker would stop by a whole motherfucking meal to get a picture and shit.
Yeah.
I'd be like, man, I have a
picture. Cause you dope, bro. Favor too.
That's why I say I can't shoot the fans away and shit. I gotta embrace this shit. Love, the fake love, all this shit, I gotta embrace
it. You gotta embrace it. It come with that.
Yeah, we on Boss Talk 101.